Hello friends, welcome to another video. It's been a long time I did any video on time intelligence. Actually, I have a full playlist on time intelligence videos. Do check out those videos. This video is based on a power question posted on Power BI community forum. Before I move forward with this video, I just want to make sure at end of this video, I'm posting a question for you guys to solve by yourself and post the answer in the comment of this video. I'm doing this because that way you guys get to do some exercise and to understand the concepts. Before going forward, let's go into Power BI and look what we're trying to achieve in this video and how we're gonna solve it. The question is pretty straightforward. I'm pretty sure you guys came across this many times. In a simple visual here, what I have is a month and the sales by month. The question was to get the sales, average of sales for the last 5 years. Again, be careful. The last 5 years does not mean that from today to go back last 5 years or the date at which we are looking at the data, go back 5 years, but the same month of last 5 years. So what does that mean is, let's say if we are in, I'm doing this video in September 2023. If I'm in September 2023, when I'm looking in September, I want to have an average of last September, 5 Septembers, like 2023, 2022, 2021, and 2019. So take that data and then get the average of that. Similarly, whatever the month I'm looking at, I just want the sales of last 5 years of that month, get the average, and then compare whatever the comparison we want to do further with that average. This is what the exact question we're going to try to solve here to see how we can get achieve that. Let's sort of write a my year. Let's call it last 5 years average. Or actually, instead of 5 years, we can have last X number of years. Maybe we want to create a parameter where user can select how many years he wants to go back. So let's keep it last X years average. So the thought process is, if we are looking in any of the year, this is the month coming from the date dimension. Again, anytime you're working with the dates, you should always be thinking of date dimension in your model and must be marked as a date table. Do check out those videos why it is very, very important. So I have a calendar table in here, which is marked as a date table. And first we need to get is, I'm gonna store, let's see how many number of years we want to go back. Just storing it in a variable. Assuming if we want to change it tomorrow, it's easier. And I'm going to call it number of years. Let's say we're going to go back 5 years. I have only 3 years data, so I'm going to keep it 3. But if you have more data, or this value can come from, again, as I said, a parameters as well. Then what we need is, we need to first find out what date we are at, because that's from where we want to go back 5 years. So let's say current visible date, which will be simply max of calendar date. Why are we using max? Again, if I'm in August 2019, my max date will be August 31st, 2019. If I'm in August 2020, if on my row, then I will be having August 31st of 2020. So that's what will give me the maximum date, what at the row level, because we are looking at the month level and we need that. Why we're storing this date in a variable? Because this is where we need to find out. We want to go back 5 years. Now, how we go back 5 years for the same month? First of all, I'm gonna create a table here. Let's call it dates table. So first we know there is a function called dates in period. What the dates in period function does is, it you give the starting date, and then you can move forward and backward with the number of years, months, or whatever the interval you give. So what we can do here is we can take advantage of calculate table. First, we're going to calculate a table. We're going to take the values of our date table, calendar date. And what we need is we need to go back 5 years from the current date, current visible date. So we know the current visible date. We already have stored it in a variable, which is current visible date. So what we're going to do is dates in period, and then calendar date, and the second parameter value is the start date. Our start date is our current visible date, and then the number of intervals. We want to go back 5 years. So I already have the number of years stored in a variable here, but that is a positive. If I give 3, it is going to forward 3 years, but here we want to go back 3 years. So that I will say minus number of years, so that will make it negative. I can also store it as in a negative here, and then just use that directly. But I'm thinking if you guys have a parameter where you want to pick the value, you will not have the minus and pluses, but it will be always you want to go back 1, 2, 3. So that's why I just kept it positive. But again, you can change it the way you want, and the interval will be a year. Now, if what this will give us is, let's think through this. If I am in December 2020, it was going to go back 5 years from December. So that will go back to a full 5 years of January 1st, 2015, right? 5 years. So that's what's going to happen. So that's what this table is going to give us now. But we don't want all other months in between, right? So what we need is, we only want the month which we are right now we're looking at. So then it means what we need to do is first a filter we provided that the values calendar date is the column we are getting from the date table that will create it as in a table. First it's going to filter for the last 5 years. And then the second filter we want to put on this one is in our calendar table, we have a month number, because if I am looking in August, I only need all last 5 years data for the month of August. If I'm looking in February, I need data for dates only for last 5 years for month of February. So what I'm going to do is calendar month number. That's just a month number stored in my table. And then I want a month of my current visible date, right? So now what happened is if we think through the from our visualization perspective, if I'm in November 2020, what I'm getting is dates in period. This will give me all the dates going back to November 2020 to last 5 years. And then we are further filtering it for the month of 11th, because month of November, because our current visible date in November 2020 row will be month 11th, right? That's November. So that's what's going to happen. So basically this dates table is now giving me all the November or whatever the row I'm at, giving me all those dates. And then what we can simply do here is we can have a calculate. Let's first just take the sum and see how does that look like. So what I'm going to do is current visible date. So I'm saying give me the sales of my current visible date. So let's see how does this looks like. We will calculate the average afterwards. This supposed to be dates table. Okay, so we have this my year now. Let's see what does that sum look like. And if I go last X year, so right now it will be hard to read here, but let's select any month here in the slicer, September. So if you look at that, September sale is 618161, so that's last 5 year. When I'm September 2019, there's no data, so I'm getting the same sales. When I'm in September 2020, now this is sum of these two months, all of both of September, so that becomes whatever that 1.1 million. And when I am at September 2021, my total sales is now 2.6 million. So basically, I'm getting some of each month from the last 5 years, 3 years in this particular example. And as you can see, the total matches the same. Here, you're getting this number because decimal. I don't have a decimal here. So even we look into any other month, so we are getting this, so the same result. Now, we are almost there. It's working. But the key is, this is very important that we are making sure that we're just getting the dates for those, that month only, the one which we're interested in, right? So now, average should be pretty straightforward. And let's store, calculate the average. There's two ways to calculate the average here, but I will show you the both way. Because you can have a different preferences here. So let's call it average. So one way of calculating the average would be, let's first get some sales. And that is our this year, which is just the sum of sales, right, for those months. And then we can say divide our total sum sales with the number of years we want the average. So that's like an absolute average here. So now let's see. As you can see, when I'm in July, so these are the months. So that's the sales for July 2019, 600,000 approximately. So divided by 3 is $200,000. When we are in July, 6 plus 10, 4, 10, 1.1 million, and divided by 3 is 355. And similarly, when we have the 3 years, it is giving me 824, like a sum of all these 3 years divided by 3, it's 824. That's the one way of calculating the average. But if you want to calculate the average, if I have only 1 year data, I don't want to divide it by 3 because it's only 1 year data, so average is wrong. If I'm in July 2020, I have a 2 years data, then I want it to be a 2 years average of 2 years. If I'm at the July, of course, now I have a 3 years data, I want the average to be of 3 years. So how we can fix that, and for that purpose, what we will use, we're not going to follow this method. But what we will use in that case, we will take advantage of average x function, which will be our values year. Now, why we are getting the value year? Because we are calculating for based on the number of years. If I have only 1 year data, then divided by 1. If we have 2 years data, then divided by 2. If it's 3 years data, then divided by 3. So that's why we want it to be whatever the number of years, because we want the average based on the years for our sales measure. But this would not work because we need to extend our range, date range, because if we just say this, it would not work, because if it is at the month level, it will always give us 1 month average. Let's actually try it. I'm going to apply this. As you can see, the average is still the same number as sales, because it is only 1 year here, 2019, 1 year here, 2020, and 1 year here, 2021. So basically, we're not getting anything out of it. What we need is, we need to expand our, change this measure to apply calculate, and then we say, okay, you know, our date range is our dates table. Here you go. So when we are in the first year, July 2019, we have only 1 year data and average is 611, because 611 divided by 1 is 1. When we have 2 years data, 6 and 4, 10, and divided by 2, it's 533. So now, because I have 2 years data, and as soon as we went to the third year, so we have a 3 years data, so this is 2.473 divided by 3 is 824 is the average. So depending on how you want to calculate the average, do you want to just straight divide by number of years, or you want, depending on the data available for based on the data available for how many years, and only calculate the average. Even we are expanding our range for 3 years, but in 2019 we don't have data for 3 years, and that's why the average x function is being used. So now this is working perfectly fine. I think that this is pretty interesting. A time intelligence question usually come. I haven't seen it many times, but I think it's a common question. It can be applied to any other time intelligence calculation where you want to compare the same periods. It could be on quarters and so forth, so on. Now, as a start of the video, I mentioned there is a question for you to solve. And the question is, for example, when I'm calculating the average, if I'm in December 2021, and I don't want to include December 2021 sales in that particular average. So when I'm in December 2021, I want to exclude the current period or current month and go back 5 years. So basically when I'm in 2021, in this particular example, my average would be 4, 5, 6, basically, because I want to take the sales of the December 2020 and 2029. So excluding the month on which I am and then calculating the average. So these averages will shift 1 month down. And because let's say if I want to compare with this last 5 year, excluding the current period, then I need to change my measure. And I'm going to leave that up to you guys. And what do you guys think, how you guys will solve it? It's pretty straightforward, but I think it will help you guys to boost your skill on DAX and the time intelligence. Again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy this video, and make sure hit the subscribe button and click the bell icon, and so that you get notified when the new video come out. And make sure to share with your network so that they can learn from this. Again, your feedback is always welcome. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day. Bye for now. Thank you.